Okay, so I have the same 24 stitches casted on. I knitted 2 rows, got my claw weights on, got my carriage set to hold. So I'm going to do 1 stitch one row, 2 stitches the next row. Again, the automatic wrapping. First I'm going to knit across. Then I'm going to take 1 stitch, pull it out to hold, knit back. Now I need to do 2 stitches. So I am going to take 1 needle, knit across, and the second one, do back. Now I got to do 1 stitch, knit across, there's the 1 stitch. I find that I do have to move my claw weights up about every 2 rows. So let's see, it's 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. 1, 2, and I noticed it didn't knit, so I had a hand knit that back. That's where moving the claw weight over is going to help you. 1, 2. 1, 2, One, two. Oops. 1, 2. One, two. Okay, so I don't even have to do anything more there. And what I can do is just take my gray yarn and bring it over off to the side, because at the end I'm going to pick up and knit 10 rows. So now, to reverse short row, they're doing the 1 and the 2. When you're reversing, you need to add 1 more stitch. So for 1, I bring 2 needles out, I push 1 back. 2 needles, I need to push 3 needles out, push 1 back. 1, 2. One, two, one, two, and then, of course, on the end, I just have the 2 stitches. So there is the end of my short rows. So now, just so that I could frog this back and I could use this afterwards, I will go ahead and just knit up some rows of gray, take it off the machine, and then put it up to what I already did to show you the difference. Okay, so here's the new piece I just knitted up, and I lined it up with this one over here. so that you could see the angle of this. So this is going to be more square, and I think this is what I should do when I make my afghan out of this. So let me measure and actually see how square this piece came out. Okay, so the point down here didn't really come, because I did two rows in the beginning there. I probably should have knit one row and then started my short rows. So I went down one point. Now I'm up one line on the gray here, which gives me a 6-inch by 6-inch square. So doing the one decrease, two decrease, or short rows, one needle, two needles, one needle, two needles, one needle, two needles, that is making it more square. Now, this is what I'm going to have to use when I make my afghan. Something else I forgot to mention is how many stitches you have working, depending on how many needles you're going to be bringing back or to hold in position. Of course, one is easy, but two, three, the total amount of stitches has to be divisible by it. In my case, 24 was divisible by both 2 and 3, so it worked out on those. Well, I hope you get to make an afghan using this technique.